forthright and fearless. Wendy Harmer is a trailblazer of the Australian entertainment industry. The journalist turned stand-up comedian made her mark internationally and came back again to become the first woman to host a TV comedy show and snag a primetime radio slot. She's seen and done it all, and she's written it all down in her new memoir, Lies My Mirror Told Me. And she happens to join us on the desk right now. Yeah. Welcome, Wendy. See you nodding along to our little intro there. You're like,
nodding or just pretending that didn't happen? not really sure.
You are a veteran, though, of the Australian entertainment, media industry, landscape, and now that you've got a tell-all out, is there anyone that should be really worried?
Well, the chapter, the Michael Hing years... Maybe, you know, you may be wanting to have a look through them, my friend. look, I think pretty much everyone gets away with everything, except there may be a few radio executives who might want to have a little bit of a look.
Really? Did you have to ring anyone and warn them?
As if I would do that.
Why ruin the surprise?
Yeah, right. You know?
Well, because I've been privy to a very special thing, which is Wendy Harmer holding court on a night out with comedians. Occasionally...
Okay, that is code for very drunk and annoying.
honestly, it's one of the best things, because you have all these secrets about the entertainment industry and everything, and I feel like you've had them for your entire life. So why did you decide to reveal all now?
Well, Michael, I got the advance 8 years ago.
The publisher was like, hey, TikTok, we've got to get this done.
And I just finished up Breakfast Radio. You can't do anything while you're doing Breakfast Radio, TV, Sarah, you know.
Your brain just doesn't work.
Yeah, your brain does not work. And so, yeah, now I get the chance. But, you know, I have been in the media. I mean, I started in media when I was 18, media and TV and radio and stand-up, and now I'm 68, so 50 years worth of stuff.
Wow.
All crammed in there. it's been... the interesting thing, of course, is that when you write... I always say this is not so much a me memoir as a they memoir, and I'm ringing all my friends to corroborate, did that actually happen? And they say no. Oh, OK. But this did. I went, oh, that's even better. You know?
That's your fact-checking. I love it.
50 years of stories and Michael Hing gets a chapter. That's
pretty darn good.
No, this is a joke, by the way.
Or is it?
Lawyers.
Wendy, I have to ask, you do write about your mantra, your stand-up mantra, but you call it the pathetic mantra.
Oh, worst mantra of all time. I decided to do stand-up comedy. There weren't any other women doing stand-up in Melbourne at that time, in about 1982. And my mantra, before I went on stage, because around me people were throwing up and they were crying in corners and, you know, whatever, and my mantra was so pathetic, I would just say to myself, and I did for years, I don't have to do this for a living. I was actually hoping to end up at a Canberra Press Gallery, but I mean, in a way, it was like it just was very soothing to me.
Because you had nothing to lose.
Nothing to lose, my dear, nothing. And lost most of it, gained a bit back, lots of more, gained a bit back, but it's been a great ride.
Oh, you're the best, Wendy Harmer. I'd love to take you back to 2002. I'm sorry. To the Logies. Let's have a little look at your turn at hosting it.
Sure.
Look. Oh, we don't have that there. There we go. It's a high wire act. You never know how it's going to turn out.
What a shame.
But you said that it was... You've described it as like cutting off your arm with a blunt chainsaw.
Oh, yeah.
What happened?
Well, the thing was that I had quite a sort of benign routine worked out because it had been a really difficult year in television. And the producer said, nah, get stuck into them because, you know, a lot of the programs had tanked. Well, that was really bad advice, as it turned out. I mean, nothing that Ricky Gervais wouldn't do now, but I was the first woman to do it since 1959.
Wow.
And so, and, you know, I was you know, pickling people, giving everyone a bit of ginger, if you like. Mm. So I came out and I did my first opening gag about Jamie Dury. That tanked. And I'm sure, Michael, that you would agree with me.
Yeah.
One of the loneliest places in the world to be is on national television while everything is just going tits up.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
And that's what happened there.
Yeah, wow.
But I'm really glad I did it. I mean, I was... did you see me pop up on the Logies this year in the cupboard?
I did see you pop up. And I didn't. I did a big cheer as well.
Yeah, yeah. I've been hiding in there since 2002. In the witness protection
program. Who else was in there, Wendy Harmer?
Oh, believe you me.
Let's not. We can't legal that. Who's next?
No. Andrew Tennant has described you as a trailblazer, which is obviously something that sounds amazing, but a trailblazer has to burn things down, you know?
Well,
so do you feel like that was a difficult... I mean, you know...
I don't think it's so much burn things down. I mean, my husband said something really wonderful, you know, and you know the saying, you can't be what you can't see?
Yeah.
He said to me... You couldn't see, so you decided to be.
Oh.
Which, I mean, isn't he nice? He's not a bad
bloke,
actually. So I could not see myself, and so I thought, you know what? I reckon I'm going to give that a red hot go. And, you know, it's paid off for me over the years.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's paid off
no
for
prisoners,
all of
though, Sarah.
You're a national treasure, Wendy Harmer.
Thanks.
Grab the book.
Yes.
It's called Lies My Mirror Told Me. It's available now in all good bookstores, even online. Wendy Harmer, always great to chat. Come see you soon.
Thank you.